Welcome to session 2 of the lesson. Flying high. In the last session we learnt about some common birds found in India and how they come in variety of sizes, colors, and make varying sounds. In this session we shall take a closer look at their body parts and functions performed by them. Let's look at the body part of a bird. A typical bird has wings with feather using which they fly. Instead of teeth they have beak. Using their beaks, they grab different types of food. They also have tail covered with feather that enable them to fly. Their feet are adapted to help them catching their food. Look at different shapes of beaks found in different varieties of birds. Their beaks are adapted to type of food birds catch and eat. Broadly we can classify the beaks as meat eater, as in the case of vultures and the eagles. They are very strong, shaped like a hook, have sharp cutting edge. Seed eater, as in the case of a sparrows and the pigeons. They are short and cone shaped. Fruit and nut eater, as in the case of a parrot. Hook is used to peel the thick skin of the fruit. Nectar feeder, as in the case of a hummingbird. Their long beak helps them probe deep into the flowers searching for nectar. Fish eater, as in the case of a kingfisher. Its beak is long, strong, and dagger-like, helping them to catch fish. Have you ever noticed that birds fly and walk in different ways? Their neck movements also differ. Based on where they stay and how they move about, birds' feet have different shape and functions. While most of the small birds hop, others can walk or run. Heron and ostriches are examples. Feet of the birds that prey like vultures and eagle have sharp, strong hooked claws. They use it to grip and kill the prey. Birds that fly usually make trees as their home and have perching feet. This helps the bird to hold tree branches firmly. Examples are sparrows and peacocks. Most of the birds that stay near water have webbed feet. This helps them to swim as well as walk in water effortlessly. Duck is an example. The feathers of birds are of different shapes, sizes, and colors. Their feathers help them to fly and keep them warm too. From time to time, birds lose their old feathers and new ones grow in their place. Feathers come in different shapes and have different functionality. Based on the functionality, we can classify feathers into three categories. Down feathers are small and fluffy and keeps the bird warm. Contour feathers are longer and stiff. They cover outside of the bird's body to give streamlined shape. Flight feathers are the longest and toughest. They line the bird's wings and tail and provide required power to flight. Here is a mapping of various types of feathers to the body parts of an eagle. Down covers the various body parts and keep the bird warm at high altitude. Contour provides the shape required to glide. Feathers for wing and tail are the strongest that helps eagle to fly high. In this session we learnt about beaks, feet and feathers of birds and how they perform different functions required for the bird to survive. With this we have come to the end of session 2.